Hi everyone, welcome again to our new session. In this session I will explain you how to prepare a test plan. So whenever we are working with the big project which contains multiple modules to be developed and tested, after verification it should jump to the or it should ready for the production deployment. So before that, whenever we are executing test cases, how our plans looks like that? So it's totally dependent on the organization to organization basis, but here I will try to cover each and every aspect so that whenever you are trying to prepare or whenever we are creating test plan, so you should include each and every component so that it will clear to every stakeholders. So test plan will helps you to define each and every aspect of the testing, module wise, even environment or which all technologies you are going to use, that should be covered in your test plan. Because whenever test case or testing execution will start, before starting there should be some plan to be shared with the product owner and various stakeholders, which they will see and provide the approval, so we are okay with the scope of the testing and other components as well. So it's always recommended to use a specific or each and every aspects of the testing which we are going to use in every phases. So let's begin with this. And for those who are new to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for the update. So here we go. So as you can see, I am using test plan in Word document. So it's totally dependent on the organization to organization basis. If you want to use it in the PPT format, that is also well and good. And whenever you are saying there are various test plan formats are available or templates are available, it's mandatory to consider all the aspects rather than using the format. So definitely PPT will help you to cover or to present each and everything in a design format, but whenever we are working with the large component of data, it's always recommended to Word file. So you can see, just like I'm taking example of testing a WhatsApp mobile application. So here you have to mention your mobile application project, on which project you are working, you can include it here as well. So this is your plan. If we are working with the test plan, there might be happen in one shot it will not approve, so we have to update our test plan according to requirement, according to stakeholder and product owner. So version will varies. So just like 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, whenever it is updated, you can increase the version up to 1.1 to it's totally dependent on the updates. So here you should mention your dates when you have created your test plan. So in the next phase, you can see here the version history. So I've just added one version. If you have updated in the next version, just include 1.1, and same should be mentioned in the top. So which version you are using, that will indicate on your whenever the person who is opening the document. So implemented by, again, Deepak Rai, same name, whoever is implemented or created this test plan. Revision date, you can add the next date, just like 24 06 2020. Approval, you can add the approved by the person name. So if you are the test lead, so your approver is definitely going to be the project lead or the product owner. So you can include the name of the person, the approval, when they have provided the approval, you can include it here, and the reason. So this is a test plan draft. So once this is approved, we are going to use in an actual scenario. So if I am going to test the WhatsApp application, my plan should be covered each and every aspects. Next page, this is the table of contents. Which page this is a very important when we are working with the test plan. So whenever anyone wants to jump to the specific component, just click and jumps to that. So table of contents is always have the name of the title name, and subtitle name is also, if you want to include in the pointer, it's well and good, or in the number. Then the page right side will indicate the page. So whatever content is available, it should be exactly matched with your page number. So I've created these many indexes. If you want to increase or decrease, you can do it according to your requirement, according to your document as well. Now, as you can see here, introduction. The purpose of test plan document is, this test plan documents and track the necessary information required to effectively define the approaches to be used in the testing of the any products. The test plan document is created during the planning phase of the project. Its intended audience is the project manager, software development team, and the software testing team. Some portion of this document may on occasion be shared with the customer, user, and other stakeholders. Just like I have said, if we are working with the chain system, in organization chain system, then we have to be careful with this document and took approval from each and every person. If one application is using by different team, so that should be approved with the all the teams, because they are the owner who is going to use the application. So next is compatibility testing. So if you are going to test the compatibility testing, you should include test tricks, what all test tricks are there. Just like if you found any defects, or the application you are going to use, or devices you are going to use, that application is not available, you can include it in the risk component. So unless and until that device is not available with you, you can not start the testing. Just like if I am using WhatsApp application in my Android device, and you want to test the same application with iOS, but iOS device is not available with you, then you can include in the risk. Unless and until device is not available with you, you can mention in the risk, and that will impact your timelines as well. Item to be tested and not tested, so totally dependent on the requirement. If the fix is for only for the video calling feature, so you can include it. We are going to test the video calling and regression of all other components. What all you're not going to test, just like version information or logo or any other components which you are not going to cover, you can include it here. So because of that, the content is item to be tested, test description, test date, and responsibility. Who is responsible for that test case? So you can include the tester name, and if you want to highlight your name itself, just like a test lead, you can include your name as a responsibility person. So what all test approaches you are going to use while testing of the compatibility testing? So you can mention here Agile, waterfall model, or Scrum. So if you want to learn more about the Agile waterfall model, please watch my previous session. Don't worry about that, I will include in my description tab. There's a test regulatory or mandate criteria. So if you are working with the banking projects, so always it is required to include the test regulatory name, and test approaches should be followed with them. Just like if you are working with the critical data, which is not going to share with the other person, or banking projects, you are working with the banking projects. So in banking sector, the data is very important and it's critical, because RBI is always creating mandate for the bank not to share the customer information with the other user. So you should mention here the regulation as, because you are going to test compliance and InfoSec testing as well. So test pass and fail criteria. So just like if it is totally matching with your BRD document, then the requirement is passed, and if it is having any discrepancy, you can include it here. Test entry and exit criteria, if all the testing is done without defect and based, if just like take one example here, I am working on the video calling feature, and video calling feature is having some glitches, and that feature is a major critical defect. Just like if you are doing video calling and video is not clear, there is no use of that application to be used, and customer is not going to focus with that application and not going to rely on that, so they will go away from using this application. So better to improve the quality. So product owner is not going to take a risk for this to be customer is going out of that application. So that defect should be fixed. If you have raised 50 defects, out of 50, product owner wants to fix that only 40 defects, and 10 they want to take ahead in the MNS project. Till the time they will work on the 40 defects and fix that, and they want to go ahead with existing 10 defects. So they will provide the approval, or they are going with their own risk. Testing team is not going to be responsible for that. So you can include it in your test entry or exit criteria. Test deliverables, so status report and the timelines. If you status report, you can include it just like timelines. So the testing team is always going to provide the timelines and status report in a weekly basis or daily basis. You can include it. So these all deliverables. If you want to include the module name as well, you can include it here. So this will become for the completed compatibility testing, just like test suspensions. If anything is describe the suspension criteria that may be used to suspend all the portion of testing, just like if application is crashing, so you can mention it here, because if application is continuously crashing whenever at the time of launching, so you are unable to test for thus at that application, so you can include it here. Test environment, which environment you are going to use, QA environment or UAT environment, which server you are going to use the, for testing the application, which all mobile devices you are going to use, that you can mention it, each and every mobile device with their OS version. If you are using iOS, you can include its iOS version as well. So Android as well as iOS, both device name with the updated version name and application version name. So you should include all three aspects at the time of test environment or staffing or training needs. Just like if staffing you are going to add or rely on the only two staffs or two testers, so you can include the tester's name here. If you need any training, just like understanding of any feature, how it is developed and what all the requirement, you can mention in the training needs. So same thing is apply with the conformance testing, item to be tested. So these all components we are going to cover again and again with each features. So test plan is always included. So if you want to create test plan with each and every functionality, you can include it each and every functionality at once. Then you can define all the aspects for all modules together, so that you don't need to write each and every. But it's always recommended to specify all the type of testing with these criteria. So better to cover each and every aspect with all the testing types. Just like load testing, if you are working with the load testing, all the data which is available in the functionality testing is not going to be same with the load testing. So we have to describe or define different criteria or different altogether data for the load testing, because for load testing we are going to include automation framework or some other tools which we are going to use, some different other devices as well. Login credential is more than 1, 2, 3. So because load testing we are going to test the load of that application, how it is behaving when millions of customers are attracting at same time. So the criteria is different here. Just like item to be tested, what you are going to test, just load your testing. So because of that, your load your testing at the time of login, at the end of any functionality uses this, like if you are considering the example of WhatsApp application, if you are having a video call with a single person, one to one, then how the video quality? If you are having a video call with the four person together, how is the video quality? So that will totally define your application strength or application efficiency, how it is reacting, how it is behaving when more than one user are using same feature at the same time. Test approaches should also be different, because you are going to perform the performance testing or the efficiency of that application, how much time it will take to launch the application, how much time it will take to exit the application, delivery of the message, how much time it is taking when we are delivering the multiple data or attachment, how much time it will take to deliver the content. So these all criteria are applicable for each and every type of testing you should include. You can see here all the details are here. So if you are going to perform the regression testing, so you don't need to perform the criticals one, because we have already did it at the smoke testing. So in regression testing, you can include only the regression of your application. So that will include medium and low priority test cases. So this is all about how we can see and the stress testing and each and every type of testing. The approaches should be same, and you should define each and every type, just like test stress issue, item to be tested, test approaches, test regulatory or mandate criteria. Whenever it is required, you can include it. If it is not required, you can remove it from there. And test pass and fail criteria, then a test entry or exit criteria, test deliverables, test suspension, assumptions or resumptions criteria, test environmental, staffing and training needs. At the end also, if you want to present this data with the top management or with the business team, or you can see just like a cost estimation, we can also include at the end of this test plan. So this is all about how we can include it for each and every type of testing. Next, we'll need to our test plan approval. So you have to include the name of the person who is going to approve. Just like in the first phase, if I am the senior tester who have created this document, so first phase approval will be test lead. So test lead is going to approve, then the test lead will send that mail or send that document with the project manager or UAT or QA team manager. So QAT or QA team manager will approve that test plan and send it to their all the stakeholders. Stakeholders, if one application is using by various teams, so all the teams approval should be required. Before that, product owner who have developed or designed this product, who will approve that, then product owner will send this test plan document with all the stakeholders and end user. So once they will approve, then the testing scope is closed. Apart from that, whenever any functionality will be introduced, that will go to the change request or in the next phase. So by this way, we can see that approval will be included. Test plan approval should be provided for each and every. So if you want to provide the reference from which documents you have created, you can include it in the BRD document, or if you are having any other document, just like validation document or any workflow, you can include all the document detail with the version and description of that. So if you want to insert any key terms which is required, you think it is required at the time of testing, you can add it in your additional comments. So by this way, you can complete your test plan report and you can go ahead with this. So this is a one template I use. You can use it this template, or there's a various templates available online. You can download it and use it for your reference, or learn it for your reference. So this is all about how to create test plan and cover each and every module or each and every aspects. Hope you understand it. If you have any queries or comment, please comment the comment section so that I will check and revert with the resolution. And don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.